Thinking about picking up a new iPhone? Just get the XR. Now, I made a video a little while ago on why you should skip the XS and the XS Max and just get the XR. And now that I've had time to play with both phones, that point still stands. Now let's go over some of the key differences between both phones. Let's start with one of the more nuanced differences, network speeds. Now the new iPhone XS and the XS Max, I'm just gonna refer to them as Max now, just as one pair, because really the only difference is the screen size. The Max is capable of 1 gigabit per second network speeds, unless you're in an area where you have that capability on your network already. Like for me, I have T-Mobile. T-Mobile doesn't have 1 gigabit per second speeds currently available in the Orlando area. So when you're comparing speeds on both phones, the XR and the Max, they are exactly identical. Audio is another area where there's some difference. There's not supposed to be, but I did notice that the Max sounded slightly better than the XR. They both have stereo speaker arrays, so they both should sound exactly the same, but it's not a big difference. It's not gonna be something you're gonna really notice unless you're looking for it. Now you wouldn't know this unless you really looked for it, but the Max does have 1 gig extra RAM than the XR. And most things you're gonna be doing on your phone, this is not gonna make a huge difference. But for those of you who open up all the apps on your phone and you just keep all the apps open all the time, you never close anything, the 1 gig of extra RAM is going to help you out there. But beyond the RAM, the Max and the XR have the same exact processor, the A12 processor, and the same exact GPU. So performance on both phones, aside from the RAM, should be exactly identical. You're not gonna notice any speed increases from the Max to the XR. They should be performing exactly identical. And battery life's another differentiator here. The XR actually beats out the Max when it comes to battery life. It has 1 hour extra battery life compared to the Max. This is probably just due to the fact that the Max has an OLED screen, which is gonna take a lot more power than the LCD screen on the XR, so that is gonna consume a little bit more battery life. Now, speaking of display, this is the big one. This is the big differentiator between both phones. The Max has an OLED HDR display, which is just gorgeous compared to the XR that just has a traditional LCD display. Well, not traditional, it is Apple's new Liquid Retina display, so it does have curved corners. If you put both phones side to side and you're playing HDR content, the Max clearly wins. There is no competition at all. The Max has a way better display than the XR. It is beautiful looking at those deep, vibrant colors and those rich blacks. That's when you put them both side to side. If you're never gonna have both phones next to each other ever playing the same exact video for some weird reason, you're not gonna notice this. This is not gonna be a huge downer for people who are picking up the XR. If you are a media junkie on your phone and you use your phone primarily for entertainment, for watching Netflix or Hulu, the Max is probably gonna be the better phone for you to get because you're really gonna enjoy that better, richer display. And if you're someone who hates bezels, the Max has basically no bezel at all. It's very, very close to the edge, whereas the XR does have a little bit more of a bezel. And the bezel difference isn't really that huge. There is definitely a much more noticeable bezel on the XR, but it is not like it's like a 1 inch bezel compared to a 1 millimeter bezel. It's very, very close. Now, the last thing when it comes to display differences is that the Max contains Force Touch, whereas the XR completely gets rid of that and just uses haptic feedback. Now, for most people, honestly, I don't think you're ever gonna notice this. And if you do, it's gonna be something minor use case where you can work around that eventually. Now, one of the last main huge differences between both phones is the camera. On the XS and the XS Max, you're gonna get that same dual camera system Apple's been doing on all their high-end phones for years now. Whereas on the XR, you're only gonna get that one single wide lens. Now, if you're someone who takes a massive amount of photos on your camera, then the XS and the XS Max are gonna be the better options for you just because you got one extra lens to use in your kit. Whereas if you're just someone who occasionally takes pictures with their phone, it's not your main camera, or even if it is, you're not really that serious about it, the XR is gonna be more than enough for you. Especially since the wide angle lens on the XS and the XR are exactly the same lens, they're exactly the same camera, you're not gonna lose any quality when it comes to pictures. Really, the only thing you're missing out on is that you're not gonna be able to zoom optically on the XR. You can still zoom digitally just fine. You are gonna lose some image quality, but you just can't do it optically anymore. And for me personally, I just don't think most people are gonna care about that optical zoom. I think they'd rather just save some money and just get that same wide angle lens and just take pictures like that. And when it comes to the front facing camera and all those Face ID sensors, they're exactly identical. There's no difference here at all. They're exactly the same camera, exactly the same sensors. So they perform form exactly the same. You're not gonna miss out on anything there. And finally, the last thing between the XR and the XS and the XS Max is color options. If you're someone who likes to style their phone to their personality or wherever it is, or just your style in general, the XR gives you a lot more options to do that. But all in all, I'm gonna make more or less the same statement I made in my earlier video before I even tested the phones. The XR is the better value phone here. Yes, the XS and the XS Max give you a much better screen, an extra camera, extra gig of RAM, and the potential for gigabit network connections. For about $200 or $300 less, the XR gives you more or less all of that with a screen that's better than average. I think it's a really great screen. I don't know what everybody was complaining about. I think it's just people were freaking out about specs, but I honestly think this is a really great screen. I don't think you're really gonna notice much difference if you never compare the two. So I'd actually recommend the XR to the vast majority of people out there. I think save the extra money, get the XR. I actually picked up the XR myself. I had the 10 last year and just the price per performance wasn't good enough for me to get the XS Max or the XS. But let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know which phone you're gonna pick up or you did pick up. Let me know any reasons you think why one is better than the other. And if you're gonna get the XR, let me know which color you're gonna get or which color you did get, I guess, if you already picked it up. And if you like the video, maybe consider subscribing. I really appreciate it. Every time someone subscribes, that means a lot to me. But as always, my name is Joshua Jabuños. Stay sexy, and I'll see you sometime.